If you look at the evidence from Australia, Western Europe, North America, all these countries have experienced rapid familial change since World War II.
I'd say in the case of these countries, these changes vary in degree, but not in kind. Contemporary family patterns in different societies tend to follow their own trajectories.
But these changes are really quite recent, and these patterns are really quite contextual. Basically, different types of families occur in different types of settings. There are specific functions, and the meanings attached to them depend largely on their relationships to the social institutions around them.
Families. Just about everyone has one. But how has the notion of the modern family changed over the past century?
When you look at the Australian family over the decades, it's impossible not to notice the remarkable changes that have occurred to its structure since the 1950s. There's this diversity, whether or not you want to recognize it, brought about by such things as de facto relationships, cohabitation, homosexual relationships. Yet these changes are really quite mainstream by international standards.
Indeed, in modern Western nations, these changes are exemplified by the emergence of new forms of relationships, which shape our understanding of the modern family unit. Divorce, informal cohabitation, and homosexuality have forged different kinds of relationships, challenging the modern notions of the heterosexual marriage and the nuclear family.
Absolutely. And if you're talking about the transformation of the family, I think the changes are pretty self-evident. But they're not global trends in any one direction. Each society's norms regarding the family unit are determined by the pervading culture, the state, the legal system, religion. Even if you consider New Zealand, which is one of Australia's closest neighbours, they are experiencing the same changes, but at different rates and to differing extents.
Yeah, bro, the changes are heaps different, eh? For example, NZ has higher informal cohabitation than the US, but the US has higher divorce rates than Canada, Australia and NZ. So there's trends, but they're contextual, eh?
But just how obvious are these westernised changes in modern Australia? According to international standards, Australia has only undergone mainstream change relative to other advanced capitalist societies. Yet, if it is true that what makes up the family unit differs to some degree across different countries, we should be able to demonstrate just how drastic these changes are by simply talking to someone from a country other than our own. We were fortunate enough to talk to Billy Low, a Hong Kong film star who had moved to Australia recently to research the contemporary Australian family.
Mr. Low, your coffee?
B.B. Rowe, most famous Hong Kong movie star. I come here to Australia to research my new role as a Jewish Australian farmer living with homosexual African American. It's played by that Samuel L. Jackson.
My research has taken me across three continents in search of what is family in Australia. Specifically, the gay Jewish farming community.
What surprised me most is how what is family here is so different to Hong Kong. I went to New Zealand to study sheep shearing, and it's different there also. They really love their sheep. I think it's different to some extent wherever you go.
But contemporary changes to the family unit, while obvious, are perceived and accepted differently. History, religion, and the state still maintain a strong influence over what is considered a family unit at any given time, in any given country. Even in seemingly progressive nations, interpretations of these changes vary wildly.
There's different viewpoints, certainly, and they can and do coexist. There's the conservative view that these trends amount to the decline of the family. Then there's the more liberal view that emphasizes diversity and flexibility.
those more conservatively inclined would definitely suggest that the family has become less stable and that it's lost its pivotal social function. What's important is that divorce, alternative lifestyles, and single parenting are seen as easy targets of this so-called decline.
We travelled overseas to learn about these different perspectives.
People have a lot of different views on the topic, but all recognise the fact that there's new types of relationships out there. Whether they do or don't recognise these relationships as family, and how these new relationships affect the family unit, is what sets each viewpoint apart.
Call me a conservative and whatnot, but it's not something that I agree with. Divorce, homosexuality, people living together unwed? Why, it's nothing short of amounting to the decline of the family as a unit. It's against my religion, and I disagree with it on principle.
It's a sign of the times, really. In westernised society, there's so many different types of relationships. I mean, you've got gay and lesbian unions or marriages, and there's open relationships and unmarried couples. And I mean, there's divorce and all that sort of thing as well. And I just think that it's really good. I think it's really progressive.
Basically, the family's changed with time. The traditional function of the family and the meaning that people now attach to it have changed. It's now more about love, intimacy, long-term relationships. At least that's how I perceive it.
To me, it's about flexibility. Of course the family has changed, but it's more about a gradual transformation. People still get married and people still have kids. But the family is different in function and structure. Marriage is no longer just an economic investment, but something based on love and intimacy. Even in Russia.
So what does this mean for the modern family unit? Can we expect to see more of the same? Will new forms of relationships, increased tolerance and changing social and cultural norms continue to influence the makeup of the Australian, indeed global, family unit?
My guess would be yes. I suppose the key thing to remember is that there has been this ongoing transformation since the 1950s in particular. New relationships are coming into play and the states are beginning to recognise the rights of new couples.
It would be difficult to argue against this logic, but I don't see a return to the traditional idea of the family. I don't know where or what the family will be like in 2-3 decades, but it will be interesting to see. Maybe one day someone will write a sociology research paper on it or something.
Sorry, I haven't started. Look that way again. Okay. When you're ready. And action. Cut. Sorry.
Do you want me to go? Do you want me to do it?
So just when you're ready. When you're ready.
Absolutely. I know the first line, it's good.
Basically, the family's changed with time. Yeah, I gotta redo that.
NZ has higher cohabitation, informal cohabitation.
Damn it. I mean, you've got hair in your face. Sorry.
It's nothing short of amounting to the decline of the family as a unit. Unit. What was that?
That was so good into it.
Unit.
Unit.
I fucked up my lines.
It is based more on love and intimacy. I stuffed it up.
Hello. My name is B.B. Rowe. Hong Kong movie star.
I'm sorry. That was great.
Okay.
That's exactly the only one.